What's up, guys? Salty Mug here. Let's play some more Life is Strange. This is episode 2, Out of Time. If you want to check out episode 1, I'll put a link in the description down below. So, let's get started, shall we? Girls' dorm? Okay.
In the previous episode of Life is Strange...
Time travel.
Whoa. What the fuck?
Yep, you got powers, girl.
Or have you done something wrong? Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No.
For reals, Warren. This is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey, leave him alone. Max? Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
It's weird that she didn't recognize her in the bathroom.
The missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago.
I mean, I guess it's
left Arcadia.
It's because of the blue hair.
Without me, something happened to her.
Wait, is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Next. Yeah, but how am I gonna stop that? Okay. Let's see what this game has in store. Now, last time, I didn't know that there was gonna be so many decision making. I missed a lot. So, I should probably... my mouse. Okay. I should probably be a little more thorough. And talk to some more people. Square Enix. I really like the music and the style of this game. Oh yeah, and if you're wondering, I'm wearing gloves because it's extremely cold where I'm at right now. And I'm a little sick. Life is Strange, Episode 2, Out of Time. Oh, look at that shirt. That's adorable. She sleeps with no blanket. Girl, you're gonna catch a cold.
Being a superhero is dirty work. I need a shower.
You dirty girl. Take a selfie.
No smiling. Take your power seriously.
But first... selfie game too strong. What's up, Chloe? Wow. Okay.
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. That's the only tourist picture I let them take of me at the Space Needle.
Where's the Space Needle? Oh, she's on top on it. Okay.
That was a good hockey game. And man, Kristen and Fernando were so drunk hanging on the Fremont Troll.
That thing looks crazy. It's like a Titan or something. Stick it out.
I can't keep my eyes open, but I know there's a scientific answer.
Time is like a river. Vortex. Okay.
Warren is blowing up my inbox now. As long as he helps me figure this out.
Wow, Doctor Who reference. That's cool.
This is so insane, it sounds logical to me.
The Chrononauts.
This wormhole thing makes total sense, but doesn't explain how I can do what no scientist. I would say this is some crazy shit, but now I'm not so certain. Should I? I thought I was into Halloween. Dana is not messing around.
Who knows? What if someone out there does have a water that plant?
It's got electrolytes.
What if someone out there actually has these powers? We just don't know. Keep calm and carry on. Okay, I need to take a shower, right?
I'll miss going to the games with my dad. Go Thunderbirds.
Let's play some guitar. You know, just to wake ourselves up. Okay. We don't have time for that. Shower supplies. Oh yeah, gotta take that.
Okay, Max. Let's hit the showers now.
My journal. Cell phone. Wow. Okay. Yeah, check yourself out first.
Hello, zombie face. This is what happens when you research quantum physics.
That shirt is super adorable.
Gordon, seriously? Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like, now. Thanks, Sherry.
Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it, consider it done.
That music.
Ow!
Hey, yo. I'll save you, girl.
Alyssa, can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy.
Yeah, no. You're not gonna hurt her.
Now that was close. Thank you, Max.
Yeah, coincidentally. Don't worry, I got you, girl.
Why, hello again, Alyssa.
Okay, Max. That's twice you've saved me from a projectile weapon. Are you my guardian angel?
Hardly. I just have a sixth sense for trouble. I'm glad to help you out.
Blackwell has a surplus of assholes. Oh, by the way, Warren said you borrowed his epic film flash drive. I didn't know you were a sci-fi geek like us. What's your favorite?
Ooh. Back to the Future.
I love Back to the Future, of course.
Of course.
Who doesn't?
Imagine going back in time to Blackwell in the 1980s?
We'd suffocate from all the hairspray.
You and Warren do know your sci-fi. Be careful. You might make Brooke jealous.
I'll just pretend I have no idea what you mean. Nice atmospheric shot. Needs dusting.
Gross. The Vortex Club are such pigs. I'm glad I pissed them off.
I didn't think Kate was like this. Macking on
these
bros.
Where's the shower?
We shouldn't be watching this.
Everybody's seen it.
You having fun in there? Shower. Okay, here.
Could be fun. Glad I'm not the only lonely nerd around here.
Hey.
Thanks for the warning.
Books are awesome. Read, kids. Ew, barefoot? It's kind of disgusting. Girl, you need slippers.
Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday.
No problem.
I needed
that. I got you.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Big time.
Isn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
Okay, note to self, bring her her book. What's her name again? Kate? Okay. Bring it to Kate. Now let's take some shower. Uh-oh. I don't know why, but it started to remind me of Heavy Rain.
What's up,
Kate?
Oh,
great.
School. That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Come on. Leave
Victoria,
her alone.
That wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh,
someday?
I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
White stuff on your face? I'm sure you're used to that.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate. Or Max.
She's such a dick.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You're
oh my god.
Such an evil biatch. I love it.
Yeah, she is. You guys watch Mean Girls? Remember that bus scene? Yeah, she deserves it. Look at that shirt. Look at those chickens. Time to erase that.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book. Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Hello? Potter?
Sorry. I forgot.
She takes a shower, then washes her face. Poster.
The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you.
Hold to another universe. Tampon poster. Hey girl, can I join you? Okay, no. Doo-doo. Rachel is a whore. Okay, let's go back to my room. I have to get that book. Wow. Nice drawing. Ooh.
No fucking
hell
way.
No.
This is not what
hell
I do with
no.
Blackwell. And I still have to clean all this crap up after I find Kate's book.
I'd be so pissed.
Oh shit. Nathan's revenge. Even Chloe told me not to go to the principal.
Man, this could almost be art if it wasn't so fucking sick and disturbed.
Wow. Man, don't mess with me. I got time travel powers. Where's the book? Where's that book?
And nothing here.
Nope. Here.
Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book.
Are you serious?
I better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems.
Luckily, you have time travel powers. Man, this would be so handy in real life.
Be gone, foul soft drink.
Be gone.
Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine.
You're mine. Okay. Let's go to Kate's.
I need to get dressed before I go there.
Okay. Wait, let's check our cell phone. Nothing new? Nope. Okay. Get dressed.
Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week. And he couldn't even rewind time.
He didn't need to. He was a genius.
Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late.
It's Kate's. I think everybody knows where I sleep.
Oh, shit. Now I'm getting anonymous threats? It never ends. This has to be from Nathan. But it could be anybody.
Could be.
Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here.
222. 222. Oh, man. It looks kind of morbid in here. Oh, she plays violin?
Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week.
No. You could be the next Lindsay Sterling. Hey.
Hey, Kate. I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies.
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate.
Hey, man.
I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
What about the video? Probably shouldn't. I'll just ask why.
Why does he think that?
Because he saw the video. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Can I see
it? Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people.
Oh.
And I have no memory of it.
Drugs. How'd you go?
So, why would you go?
I mean...
lapse of sanity? I just thought I could meet some new people.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine. And then I drank water.
Are you sure?
Are you sure it was just one sip?
I take a sip at church and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
That's what I'm thinking.
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Oh, whoa. What happened? Whoa.
Go on.
My bad.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Nathan? Really?
Nathan Prescott?
Oh, no.
He was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice.
What Man, next? That guy...
All I recall is driving for a long time. And I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white.
Oh.
Right.
Go on.
Freaking Nathan.
I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck.
Oh, shoot.
And...
Are you sure?
Are you sure? Of course. You think I'm making this crap up. Why?
No, I don't.
I'm just being deductive.
I just want to make sure all the details.
Then what happened?
That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next
day. Oh my god.
I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
She could have been raped.
Who took the video of you at the party?
Stupid Nathan. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag.
I'm sorry, girl. That really... Stupid Nathan.
So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
Oh, shiz. Maybe I should look for proof first, because they're a really rich family, and they have a reputation, so they could be controlling the cops, too, just like the principal. So, it'll be probably better to look for proof.
If you do that, they won't believe you.
Look
You're
for proof.
You're on video grabbing at all those guys.
You guys should look for proof.
Bad,
but I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this.
Yeah,
the video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
I'm sorry.
No, Kate.
It's the truth.
I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you,
but not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
No, oh my god. You took that the wrong way. We can't just jump
Good
to the
job,
cops.
Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened.
Yeah, I mean... That's what we gotta do. Sorry.
Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive.
The art style looks like that one Japanese animation, Shin-chan.
Why did she cover up the mirror? She can't look at herself?
Okay. Now I'm supposed to meet my friend. Food. Two whales. See you there. Dude, I mean, they text extremely fast. Like, there's instant texting and there's preemptive.
Hey, Brooke.
Preemptive.
Oh, hi, Max.
Empathy. Can't talk. It's early. Okay. Do you see snow? You look distracted.
You look distracted. Everything cool?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
I will
later.
Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max.
My
I'll
boyfriend?
See you around.
Or boyfriend. Okay. Let's go get some food. Look, it's the worker guy.
The birds bird are flocking around Samuel.
Bird day. Bird day.
Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max. I do love the early morning.
Oh, my God.
Everything is so calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
I mean, he sounds like he's nice, but he also sounds like a creeper. Oh. Like the light whispering. Animals.
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
The squirrels always come in the morning for food. I can hear them whisper. What animals do you sing in the forest?
Oh my God. I saw a doe.
Don't laugh, but I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me. Like it was trying to communicate.
Oh, that's your spirit animal.
It's my Patronus.
Nothing weird there, except you saw yours.
Harry Potter reference.
Your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
Squirrel!
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
He talks to himself into a third degree.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
Of course I will. Okay. That's not creepy. Is that window broken? Still?
The window was still broken after I warned Alyssa about the rogue football. One little thing changed the course of that window's life.
Oh well.
Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
Okay. Let's not fight.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk. For once.
You're
fine. Yeah, come on.
Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Kate's video.
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo-hoo. That's what happens when you preach to everybody about sex. She'll live.
Okay.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
Bossy best friends?
I guess I've had mean, bossy best friends too. Better than having mean, bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever.
Oh,
we've had our talk.
I'm sorry. Wait. Rewind? No.
Taylor.
Conversation over.
Nah. Okay. Hello? What? What the heck? I haven't been
Max,
sending emails.
Warren, what are you doing
What up?
Here?
What up, Sapphire Geek?
Nothing. Waiting for a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway. I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
That was intense.
That was intense. Everything happened so fast. I owe you.
Yeah, you handled yourself.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick.
Uh-huh.
I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
Just a pirate. You don't
just
need to know
her. Just a
pirate
I used to know.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star. Which begs the question, Why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
His shirt says meow with a box. Don't get involved, bro. Should I be honest? I already told him about my power. I mean, I might as well.
I busted him in the bathroom yesterday with a gun. I'll give you the story later. Principal Wells is taking care of it now, I hope.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
What? Do not... Stop. Don't say that. Let's go ape! I got... Sure, whatever.
Yes, that's exactly what I need. I love those old school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info.
You calling me easy? Huh? Huh? Calling me easy?
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
Blackwell Academy Transportation. What's up, bro? Cool story? Is that what that said? Yeah, more music. Small town. Did I make the 40-minute mark? This is such a driving a car type of song. Just looking out the window, thinking about everything in life. Two whales. Look at those whales. Alright.
Talk
What's
about
up, guys?
Going back in time. The diner.
No time for chit chat. I'm a millionaire. Yep. Got my lottery ticket right here. Waiting for the bus so I can cash it in.
Alright. Congrats, bro.
Hi. You look lost.
Close. Do you know if the bus has come yet? The online schedule isn't working.
I just got off.
I just got off the school bus, but I'm sure the regular bus is coming too.
Oh, that's a relief. I can't be late for this job interview. Can't believe I have to take a bus all the way to Newport just to find a second job.
Are things that bad here?
Where are things good? I can't even afford to live here.
Wow.
Well, good luck.
Thanks, I sure need it.
Right then. Save our city.
Look at all these flyers. It's so sad that nobody will read them.
End a man-made drought. Oh, okay. The wildlife.
Good morning. Looks like you're ready to catch some serious fish.
I wish, young gal. Arcadia Bay just isn't the same fishing town I grew up in.
Why?
Has the town changed much?
By Neptune's beard, it has. Seems like a lifetime ago when I was king of the harbor.
You have your own boat?
I call her the Bali High.
Bali High.
Kept a hold of her in these lean days. Might be all the time we've got left.
I thought one of Arcadia Bay's main exports was fish.
Oh, the fish used to jump onto my boat until the Prescotts and their finance fiends snapped up harbor rights.
Those rich people.
The Prescotts have a lot of power.
Exactly.
They might rename the town Prescott Bay.
Oh, come on.
Tells you much.
They own my school.
They own my school.
Crooks gain respect when they put their names on schools and libraries.
Exactly.
Let's not get downcast. I hear the fish calling for Bali High. Never forget that old fishermen never die. We just smell that way.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there.
Have fun. Yeah, that's why I think it's a good idea we didn't go to the cops with Kate's problem. Because who knows?
Man, that smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware.
Sup, man?
Hello, sir.
Hi, young Packin. Lady. You look a little lost.
Just hungry.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now, that is a real problem at the Two Wells. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese?
How well do you know Joyce?
I know her delicious grub. Everybody at the station comes here. We take care of this place like it's our own kitchen. And Joyce, like she's our mother.
Mama Joyce.
So, you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce.
Just oh, yeah.
Just got busted with pop.
That's Chloe's mom. I told you.
Who told you that?
I didn't hear it on the police scanner. Joyce said the weed belonged to Chloe's friend, but I highly doubt that.
Joyce didn't tell
you.
She wouldn't. Afraid I'd go arrest somebody, as if I would. I'd just tell the loser to stay the hell away from Chloe, or else. I'm just kidding. Besides, David Madsen's watching over. Is she a friend of yours?
I know her.
Then you know she's a handful.
She can be.
She can be, but she can also be a good friend who shows up when you need her.
Sounds like you're a good friend. I wish she would be a great daughter and not cause Joyce so much stress.
I mean, what about David?
I guess you're friends with David Madsen.
I wouldn't use that word. We know each other. Why do you ask?
Just curious.
Just curious. I'm surprised he's not a police officer in Arcadia Bay.
I have respect for David. He served his country. He found his calling at Blackwell. At the station, we're happy David is exactly where he is. Not everybody can be a cop.
I have to go now.
That would be scary if he was a cop.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
Usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Now I want to check it out.
The guy who lives in it, Frank? He's pretty sketchy himself.
Frank.
That's all I can say for now. I should finish up my coffee and get to work.
Wait, where's Chloe? What's up, Trevor?
Hey, Trevor.
Holla, Max. By the way,
holla.
I saw me in the dorm.
Holla. Dana's room?
Yeah, I saw you coming out of Dana's room.
What did they do?
I finally had to tell Justin because, well, he was into her too.
How did Justin react?
I got him blazed. He was cool. Nobody has secrets in Blackwell anyway.
Okay.
Same class, Max.
I do.
What's up, Justin?
Getting my coffee on before I cut class and destroy some rails.
Shouldn't you be taking photos?
I am.
I am always taking photos. I am a camera.
You crack me up, Maxer.
My face is a camera.
So I'll laugh at anything.
You should be studying, bad boy.
So where's all your homework, schoolgirl?
School? Speaking of buds, I saw your bro Trevor sneaking out of Dana's room.
Trevor finally told me about him and Dana hooking up.
Huh.
He got there first, so I snooze and I lose. See you later, wow. Max.
That's like true broship right there.
What do you want? I feel like shit. Too much beer, so spare me, please. Just let me suffer quietly.
Okay, calm down.
I don't feel like talking right now.
All right.
I gotta deliver a load of breakfast to my stomach. Over now.
To my stomach.
Hello?
Pardon-moi, but you're in my eyesight.
Pardon-moi.
Isn't everything in here within eyesight?
I don't care for your tone. You sound like Joyce.
What the hell?
How does Joyce sound?
Bossy and smartass. Like you.
You're rude. Joyce rules.
Joyce rules. I want to be exactly like her when I grow up.
Exactly.
Looks like you're on your way. I've been coming to this dive for 3 years, and Joyce gives me shit like it's going out of style.
That's how she rolls. That's why I worship her every move.
She feisty. Yeah.
I can't wait to see you flipping greasy bacon in a diner when you grow up.
Oh,
exactly,
okay.
Exactly like Joyce. Now pardon me while I get back to my coffee.
This guy needs to get punched in the face.
Drool. Want everything.
Can we change the music? Guitar. Oh, super country.
I got you, babe. How apropos. But no fucking way.
Alright then. Fishing.
Forgot about the fishing wall of fame.
Hey, Joyce. Where's Chloe? Oh. Have to wait for her? That booty do.
And there she is. A lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
All these years?
You still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But I wish you'd been here to help save Chloe. She got busted yesterday smoking out. Again.
I know. Chloe told me that her stepfather hit her.
I am sorry that was your introduction to David. I hope you get to know him on your terms, not Chloe's. He's a good man. He just...
Yeah, I'm sure he is since you married him, but... Don't be so harsh on Chloe.
It's good you're here. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
She understands.
Chloe understands. She just needs time. I know that sucks for you.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings,
blue hair.
Now she's got to rebel against her stepfather.
I see why.
I have a feeling the stepfather or David has like PTSD. Oh, David hit her.
Well, Chloe texted me that David slapped her yesterday.
Yeah.
He feels awful. and he will be punished. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
Yeah. Cares so much he puts cameras up and spies on people. Oh, shit. Should I bring that up? I get it,
Joyce. I know Chloe still likes to stir things up.
Yeah, she does provoke people, especially David. I just want us to be a family soon. I guess it's all about time.
I think you're right, Joyce.
So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
Ooh, bacon. Okay.
I was dreaming about your bacon omelet.
Who doesn't love bacon?
Now finish your coffee.
And eggs. That sounds so good right now. Where is my friend? Drink.
Bacon at 12 o'clock high.
I love the delicious. This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
I love the delish.
Nerd graffiti. Warren must have been here.
This is a diner, not a bar.
The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices.
How much did I pay? Bacon omelet. $6.50? Aw, dude, I want some. It's pretty okay prices. Dang. Okay.
No beer?
Looks like you had plenty. Stick with bacon.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now.
Yeah, you can.
But then it wouldn't be a moment.
Dim Kodak
no
moments.
Beer? What kind of dive is this?
Bottoms up.
This is like fourth dimensional deja vu.
Okay. Where is Chloe?
You'll love this.
Oh, okay.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh.
She doesn't look like a woman.
Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
No, you're not. This is my treat. To you, for coming back to rescue my daughter.
Nobody needs to rescue me.
Unless you set your room on fire smoking out.
Oh god, here it comes.
Well.
Didn't you and Sergeant Pepper already read me the riot act last night?
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
No, one
you
slice.
You're still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox? Now that that's out of the way.
That's my jam. Rock it out.
Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
Can I touch people and rewind it?
Here, now.
So they won't be affected?
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have x-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
You have a tube of glitter in there, right?
Nada. Wrong answer. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets.
Coins.
That was beyond epic fail.
A note.
Wanna believe you.
Rewind time now.
You need to look at the items and we'll... Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't
panda key. Got SIGs. 75, 80, 86. Parking ticket. Okay. Oh.
You got this, Max.
Time to go back.
And blow Chloe's mind.
Oh. Sorry, my recording got cut off. Anyways. Let's blow Chloe's mind. I like how she has to put her hand up.
Well, this is me telling you what's okay. Inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Hella ready. Got keys?
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
You got a panda.
A cute robot panda keychain.
It's a robot?
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
The Irish. Oh, wait. No, that's not... I said it like a Scottish. Parking ticket.
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
Oh, shiz. I didn't think about that.
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time.
Hey.
Even a broken clock is right twice a day. Whatever the hell that means.
You got cigs?
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
Are you kidding me? Seven.
Seven cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes.
Bam! Oh,
amazing.
I got memory power.
Something else in my pockets?
Money.
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
86. I count
86 cents.
That's right. Living large.
I got math skills.
Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck.
I got powers.
You have powers.
Take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
Yes, Mom. Otta.
How's the food, Max?
She has sausages.
I
love
very
meat.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
Ha. Song reference.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
Can I take her back in time with me?
No way.
Okay.
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Okay, broken cup. Cop say something. Siren. Friends fight. Let's do this. I hope. What's up, girl?
I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so.
Okay. Trucker.
The trucker drops his mug and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
Alert on cop's radio and he... He answers.
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio and he answers it.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
And Joyce Actually, no. He didn't answer it. Stops them.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
I need to rewind.
You still need to tell me one more event, Max.
Oh, I missed one? Crap.
Oops.
Dude, did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a
I think
dick.
Not,
slap
Max.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is kay. Wild.
One more. Have to wait.
Sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So that's four. Let's speed this up. Okay.
I'm going to predict.
All right, let's get this right. Drops his mug.
The trucker drops his mug and...
Okay.
So, what happens next?
And he and his partner leaves.
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Okay.
Well, let's just see how this goes.
Okay. Joyce stops
Justin
him.
And Trevor are fighting and...
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
Okay, one more. And as the trucker plays a new song.
The jukebox goes crazy as the trucker tries to play a new song.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Did I make the right choice?
Break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
Bye bye.
You're a dick.
Oh, so cool.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild.
Look at the cockroach.
This is a sad day in Maxville.
This is sure the hell.
Okay. I missed that one.
I'm going to predict.
Okay.
The cop.
Well.
Okay.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
There we go.
Oops.
Did you break another cup?
Oh,
really?
Go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called him. But he's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened!
Wow.
Grow up.
Okay.
You made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
Mm-hmm.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that.
Irony.
Check out your nose.
Oh.
Much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again.
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power.
What if
you need
using your powers
okay.
has a side
effect.
Find
the way to Chloe's cave.
Just like, you know, all in other TV
Chloe
shows.
Chloe finally believes me. And I wonder what kind of crazy shit she has in mind now.
Forgive my nerdy set coming out, but I know in Heroes, Hiro Nakamura, the guy with the Asian guy with the time travel powers, I know his side effect was that he started to age, like, ever so slowly, every time he used it. Or, he started to age more, and show effects of, like, you know,
okay, every time Supergirl, he uses powers. Let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go, and what we do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years, and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Hey, hey.
I've got other people to hang out with, too.
Don't... I have to answer.
Hey, Kate.
She's in trouble right
What's
now.
Up? Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay? I promise, Kate. I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Hey, at least I answered. At least
Thanks,
I
Max.
Care.
If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now. Let's rock.
Okay. I'm just being a good friend, you know?
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument. I could rewind and not answer Kate. It's not like I won't see her in class later.
Mm-hmm. But you never know. Sometimes a single call can save someone's life. The town dump. Uh-oh, I see a train.
Is this a race?
Remember that trailer?
Keep up.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly supersized. Why it's time to have fun.
Supersize me.
David might be a douche, but you did steal his gun. Is everybody armed in Arcadia Bay now?
Only the ones who shouldn't be. Like Step Dildo. Until now.
Yeah.
I'm not in the
Stupid
revolution
Warren.
Yet, Che.
You are the revolution, Max. So we should figure out how to best use and abuse your power with a test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit.
You don't want a drunk time traveler.
Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
Like green bottles or plastic? You want plastic? The heck? An old camera. Ooh.
Beyond repair.
Okay, never mind.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace, little camera.
I wonder how many generations of fashion went through that washing machine.
Got one. Oh, I see a squirrel.
Hello,
squirrel.
One.
Hello, squirrel. Oh, hi, squirrel. Where are you going? Aw. Hi there. I can't believe I have to look for 5 bottles. Come on. I'm a time traveler.
Thanks for the tip.
I don't... Whoa. Whoa. What is... What is this?
This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel.
Oh.
I bet I can find out more about Rachel here. Boom. Only 3 bottles left.
Chloe and her that one girl. Best friend.
I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this? So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared.
That's kinda scary. What's up, Warren? Oh no, Warren is my best friend. My bad. Too late. Freaking flirting.
They would have gone all the way to Los Angeles for a rave. Looks fun.
Dang. From Oregon?
Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachel.
Aww.
That kind of hurts.
Aww.
I can't see Chloe playing with makeup.
Ooh, mixtape.
Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape. They really were besties.
Oh.
That could have been me instead of Rachel.
Paper ball.
Now, what's up with this weird secret relationship? Sounds like Rachel was confused about it, maybe even ashamed. Wishing their names. I better not show this to Chloe or she will be seriously hurt.
Okay, if you guys want to read it, just pause the screen. For the sake of time. Okay. It's loud.
All this rusted metal makes me feel serene. Am I morbid or just goth?
Or both.
I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy.
Bridge to where? To Terabithia?
Oh, gross. So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground.
Yeah, it could have AIDS or something. Gun shells.
Those shells look fresh.
Ooh, fresh. Oh. Chloe goes here to like take out some pent up rage. Or something. Where are the bottles? Sign.
No way! I totally remember going there when I was a kid. I loved the Hush Puppies.
Hush
Puppies.
Now
the sign is just Arcadia Bay junk.
Where are the bottles?
I don't want to go that way.
Okay then. Me neither. Okay, come on.
I have to find dirty-ass bottles while you chill.
I know.
Not fair. I have to prep the range, crybaby. And I've been tripping hard about where you got this rewind power. From God or the gods. So
bow.
We can make
kneel
the world
before
bow.
Max.
Are you ready for that?
What'd she say? No.
No way. I still don't even know how my power works. Or for how long.
Dude, you fuck shit up, you rewind, you fix it. Drop the mic, boom.
Spin, rinse, and repeat. I'm just altering time and space.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, and history.
No big deal.
No biggie. You already altered history by saving my life, smartass. Let's see what else you can do.
Oh, okay. Let's play God. Oh, okay. Football.
The Bigfoots were here. Where to find bottles?
That's a weird football.
Maybe in an old refrigerator.
Old fridge? Oh, hey.
Way heavier than I thought.
Ugh. Don't worry, you're buff. You got this. This is definitely not
three
dangerous.
Down, two more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack.
I wish my nose wasn't so clogged up. Yeah, take a seat. Take a breather.
Although this junkyard is a dive, I see why Chloe hangs here. She's a steampunk. It actually feels like Chloe and her kids again.
I love steampunk. Steampunk.
Despite all the chaos and bullshit, I feel so giddy hanging out with her again. I'm so happy. Like we've both gone back in time.
Hey guys, sorry I had to cut the episode short. I'll be uploading the second part ASAP. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.